Hi guys,
welcome to another episode of Hot Toys Talk. I'm Paul.
I'm Tom.
And today we're going to be talking about a lot of new figures that were released or shown. We're definitely going to be talking about Black Widow and Hawkeye from Captain America Civil War. They were released.
We're going to talk about Rogue One, the figures that have been released. That we're going to talk about them and the new Stormtroopers that you're getting that we've never seen, so that's going to be very interesting. We're also going to be talking about Force Awakens, Luke Skywalker. We're going to be talking about that.
Definitely.
Anything else?
I think that covers this episode. So right away we'll talk about Civil War, two figures for Civil War, which were Black Widow and Hawkeye. What's your thoughts on the figures, Tom?
My thoughts on the figures, personally, is I think Black Widow, they've kind of nailed her. They've got her real hair. They've got her like real hair, and her hair's all long, and it's really, you know, it's well. The right word to be used is it's real. It's actually, I know the first figure was technically real hair, but this figure's actually like been combed and shaped to look more authentic and make her look more kind of real and alive. Kind of look real, like oh, she's really awesome to look at, you know. So, you know, I think they've kind of nailed it to a T, you know. I think they've made her perfect. And
would you get a Black Widow?
I don't know, I'd maybe pick up her. I don't, it would be hard to track down the old ones though, so.
Yeah, definitely.
But she obviously, and obviously Hawkeye, he comes with his obviously accessories, all his wee arrows and stuff, and he obviously comes with the wee Ant-Man on his wee arrow and stuff, which is pretty cool. And
you've been wanting to get a Hawkeye for quite some time.
And obviously, as they says, they said, guys, that when you look at the Hawkeye, when it's online or whatever, it doesn't tell you, it actually comes with his actual bow that actually turns into a stick. Well, they got the Budget Star actually announced that it does actually come with that. It, because they had it in the secret base over in Hot Toys, and the actual staff is there. It's the bow and it's turned into a big staff where he uses to hit the people and hit them and all that. So it actually does come with a staff, so that's pretty cool. You know, they would be nice to pick up, you know, there's so many, but Marvel, man, there's loads, there's Iron Man.
Civil War never really did it for you. You were leaning towards Batman v Superman.
I did, I went towards Batman v Superman. I'm sorry, Marvel fans out there, but I honestly preferred Batman v Superman movie than really the Captain America Civil War, because for me it was just action-packed and it was brilliant, laid out. The film was totally perfect, the way it was all scripted and the way it was all performed by the actors. It was perfect from start to finish. It was brilliant.
It was really good.
Brilliant movie.
But yeah, they're good. They look good figures. I mean, if you're collecting all the Marvel figures, which are probably a lot now, then you might as well pick these ones up, I suppose.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely.
Only if you're a big Marvel fan.
Definitely.
We may as well jump in and talk about the Rogue One figures.
Yeah.
I think the Darth Vader that we saw and all the other Stormtroopers that we saw, but we thought we were getting the
Empire Strikes Back line,
which is the only one we've really only seen, I suppose, from Empire Strikes Back, is now just Yoda.
Yoda, I think.
And then Boba Fett, Boba Fett's kind of counting for, you know, it's mostly counting for Return of the Jedi because you get the Sarlacc
pit. Boba Fett is really Return of the Jedi because you get Sarlacc pit.
Yeah, Rogue One figures. We saw Darth Vader.
Darth Vader, you saw obviously a normal Stormtrooper. You saw a Death Star Trooper, which looks very different. And you saw another kind of Trooper. I don't know if he's a desert type Trooper or whatever it is, but he looks quite cool. And they come with quite cool accessories, you know, guns and the helmet looks weird and different and all that.
I think it looks really
obviously that. Obviously, that you said yourself, it's cool. Darth Vader actually comes with like a bonus type background thing that you can put behind them to have that cool effect. So
that's really cool.
That's awesome.
Would you get any Rogue One figures?
I would. But what I want to do is I want to go and see the film first. then
what's your thoughts about, okay, like you're collecting the, you know, a New Hope figures at the moment and stuff like that. What's your thoughts about like the fact that, you know, you missed out on the Stormtroopers 2-pack? What's your thoughts of just like missing out on that Stormtrooper 2-pack entirely and just going for the actual, well, not missing regular Stormtroopers again from Rogue One?
But not necessarily, because I could, you, as you always say, you can always get it further down the line. You're not just missing out, you can go down the line and order it eventually.
Aye, but basically the Rogue One Stormtrooper, like that Rogue One Stormtrooper, the original, that's just a New Hope Stormtrooper.
But I know, but still you're getting
just
that,
getting a fancier background and maybe a fancier stand.
But you're getting it in a 2-pack, you're getting two Stormtroopers, and plus one's taller and one's smaller if you look properly. One's shorter and one's taller, so look at that Luke Stormtrooper as well. I mean, yeah, I know that's just a Stormtrooper and Luke's head on it, but
I know.
Still.
What did you think when you never told everybody about how you posed your Darth Vader?
Well, it was still technical, obviously. Got a lot of photos to take of that. I will eventually get that photos, guys, and I'll post it to Paul and he'll put it up on my YouTube channel. I struggled to get the arm with the light. I struggled to get the batteries into the arm, but once I got it, that was it. I was like, that's it, you know. I struggled with this to get this in, and I've got it, switched it on, the lightsaber turned on, went red, I went, right, awesome, cool. Put the arm in, took the arm out, the arm that he's got in, put the other arm in, and it just kept sliding out. It was horrible, and plus you can't pull up his jumper that he's got, because it's all in a one piece, so you can't actually undo it. You've got to slightly pull it up like that. You've got to just keep pulling it up and pulling it up, and then look where the joint meets the socket, and then pop it in.
I was having problems with it, because I thought I had it in, and then I would feel it it all back up again. I'd feel it, and it's not popped back out. And I'd have to go back in. Did you have that problem?
But yeah, I had that problem. But see, as soon as I popped it in, I heard the wee click. I went, right, it's getting left, and I just moved the arm up with the lightsaber. Had one of his arms that he holds it, but I couldn't get the arm up right, because every time I did that, it didn't look right, so I just had his arm kind of like that, on his belt and all that, with the jacket.
Did you get the...
With the coat, and then I had the arm, and then I managed to get his glove and his sleeve thing back on, and then I just pulled it on, flipped the switch, and then the red lightsaber came on.
Did you get batteries in
then? So I got batteries in, and that was it. So I've got him standing with his red lightsaber, and I'll get photos up, guys, for you to see. It looks awesome, it does look awesome. I don't know if I'd ever strip him down to get the batteries in the back of him. I'd probably look for a professional who's good at doing that. I wouldn't want to dare try it myself, because I'd probably damage the figure and damage bits in his belt and whatnot. I'd look for somebody that's really good at they've got really good fingers, delicate fingers, that they could maybe do it for me. You know, I wouldn't want to dare try it myself. I'd end up ruining the figure, and he'd be ruined, and then that would be it, man.
What's your next one? Is it the Michael Keaton 2-pack?
My next one will be Michael Keaton in that. He's going to be my next one. I probably won't get him at the end of this month. I'm going to just put a deposit, because he's a lot of money. And
probably November's?
It'll be probably November, yeah. I'll probably pick him up then. I'll pick him up, get him in the Batman, get him, and then after that, I've just got Leia and Obi-Wan, and then obviously my Deadpool, he'll be coming in, and then...
Oh, I know, I can't wait to get that on the show.
Can I get Deadpool?
Anyway, guys, that's it for this week's episode. I hope we've covered it.
Nope, sorry. I've just cut in there. We've also got another figure. I have to correct Paul here sometimes. We've got one more figure to talk about. We have Force Awakens Luke Skywalker.
Oh, we do, actually.
We get Force Awakens Luke Skywalker.
I forgot about that.
Yes, so give him a hit in the head. Force Awakens released the photographs of Luke Skywalker. We knew he was coming. We didn't know when until, I think it was last month.
Yeah.
You sent me a photo saying, look what we're getting. And bang, photos popped up, Luke Skywalker. Even though I know he's only in the film for like a minute or two at least. And you just see him, you see the hand and all that, and you just see him taking the hood off. we're still getting that, and you're actually getting them with the hand and all that. With it, just yeah, for me.
Apparently, that you get a alternative hands. Where you like,
yeah, that's what I'm saying. But he'll probably be like Robocop. He'll be like that type of fingers and all that. So that'll be really cool. He does look good. See, he'll probably be a good price as well. I think.
At least you know your first Force Awakens one.
But
is going
here's
to be.
The thing, though. We figures being skyrocketing up because of that Brexit thing. They'll be like £300.
They're in the UK. That. But then, Jim, he did say about getting it pre-ordered from the store.
Pre-ordered, true.
Might actually be a bit cheaper. So, I mean, we could be looking at maybe £240, maybe, I don't know, £250.
Possibly.
Do you know what I mean? Well, which I don't really mind paying that. I don't want to pay £300 for that.
All yet. I know is a good thing. I looked at my receipt, and my receipt says I've got 5,400 points, which all you do is you move the decibel point one place, and then that tells you how much money you have. So all I had to do was move the decibel point behind the 4, and then that meant it's 54.00, so I've got £54 on my card. You, I think, Jim says you've got like...
I think it's 150. 100
and something, yeah, you've got 150
on my card.
150 or something, so...
Which, another £50 and I'm closer to at least nearly close to
Well, no, it wouldn't be like £50. You would need to put, like, because you've got to remember, you put £50. That £50 would only essentially be... That would only be every penny to that, so that would be...
But I could technically pay £50 to a figure, I know.
No, but what I'm saying is, if you wanted, like, £200 onto that card... You'd have to pay in the £50, that would be, what would that be, because I'm £54 right now, I paid like £4.50.
Have you got a certain figure that you want to get on them?
I have to pay a lot.
I've already made mine. Mine's is going to be...
You're going to be Sigourney Weaver, we know that.
I really want to get that. That's what I want to use my card, get a free figure with that. That's my goal. Take a figure that you want, that you know is coming down the line, set a goal for it, that's a figure you want to get free.
I don't know, I'll wait until I've built up a lot of points and see what's out. By the time I've got a lot of points and then look and go, that's out, I've got points in my card to get that. Do you know what?
But then, again, I'm thinking... Keep it going, like.
Aye, that's what I'm thinking.
The Ghostbusters and all the Blitzway Ghostbusters, keep it going and build up more points. Think how much you would get for the Blitzway Ghostbusters if you just added all that right on top of the points you've got now.
You would.
And then obviously you still need to get. You've got Kylo Ren.
Yeah.
You know who else have you got? You still to get. You've got loads.
Well, that's true. I've got Jim's helped me. Guys, he's helped me a Kylo Ren, so. That'll be good. That'll be my first Force Awakens figure to get, so that'll
and
be...
And Ray, I don't know if you're going to get me hold your Ray.
Might get that, I might. I'll just wait.
I've got them holding me. These are the ones that I've got. I've definitely got Boba Fett.
Yeah,
which you missed Boba Fett, because obviously you had a lot. I've got Boba Fett. I've got Superman from Batman v Superman.
Yeah.
I've got the... I've got the Finn and...
Stormtrooper.
I've got that, and I've got Ray. And BB-8. So I think he's holding me quite a lot for that. So I don't really want to push and get any more.
Oh, he's holding me a lot.
Obviously, also I said to him about getting Yoda.
Getting Yoda, yeah.
So, I mean, that's quite a lot, guys. So hopefully I get them pretty soon. And I think my next one, sure. I says I'm going to go for probably trying to get Finn and Shock Trip at the road. Because it's a two-pack thing. So I'll probably put a deposit for that then.
Yep.
Anyway, that's it for this week's episode.
Yep.
Thanks very much for watching. Until next time, guys, keep collecting. Take care, guys.
Take care.
Bye-bye.